Hi, in today's video, you will learn how to add subtitles like this in your video in 3 easy steps. On this channel, I teach practical creative knowledge, so don't forget to subscribe. And now we will open our video editing software. I will use Premiere Pro, but you can use basically any software, Final Cut, DaVinci, or again, any other software. It will work. So here we have 2 clips from my recent podcast. And I want to have it on my Instagram or TikTok. And of course, I want to have subtitles because now everybody has subtitles. The first step for us is to create a green screen. You can use in Premiere Pro Color Mate, or you can just download green screen 4K image. It will work perfectly fine. So I will use my Color Mate green screen and drag it to the length of my video. And now, if you're following me, you will have only green screen and the audio. No image and no video, I mean. And the next step is to export that video and next upload it to Riverside on video or any software that provides visuals for the subtitles. Of course, we can have subtitles in the Premiere Pro, but we want to have this visual. So I will use Riverside, because that's something I use for my podcast. And luckily for you, I already uploaded the video because it takes time to upload and process. So let's go to the video. Let's go to create new edit. And you will see your subtitles. And of course, you need to check them before making the design. And because, for example, over here, I have a great example. I have a word stick-to-iveness. I don't even know if it's a word, but when we add the captions, so you go in Riverside, you go to the captions, you wait, then you add the captions, you place it in the center, or it doesn't really matter if it's in the center or not. Then you choose your ratio, 16 by 9, 9 by 16, or 1 by 1. Because we have Reels and Instagram and TikTok, we'll use 9 by 16 and place it in the center. It's just easy to have it in the center, just too easy to work with. So as you can see, we have here stick to iveness, and you need to work with that so it looks better than this, right? And you may also have some mistakes, and you may have like and other words that you would want to remove from your subtitles. One thing to remember is you need to have a solid background for your subtitles. So you cannot have this style where you have like 50% opacity. So we will choose like a white background, and maybe we will use also Enter to have like bold font. You can also play with the size, but for me, medium is pretty good. You can also have like highlight box, but we will not have any animation. Again, you can add that. That will not affect your workflow. So now we have, we checked our captions, we have our green screen, we have our captions in the center. The next step is to export that video. So again, luckily for you, I already exported the video because again, it takes some time. In the Riverside, it's not that easy as in video, but I prefer Riverside. So next, you download the video and you upload it to your Premiere Pro. You need to replace your green screen without subtitles with green screen with subtitle that you exported from Riverside. So let me just drag that over here. We will remove our green screen and we will unlink the audio. Again, can be done in Final Cut. I originally came up with that idea in Final Cut, so that can be done in Final Cut easily. So unlink the audio because we already have that audio. You don't want to have that duplicate. And now if you're following me again, you will see green screen and subtitles and the audio. The next step is for us is to go to effects in Premiere Pro or the same effect that I forget how it's called in Final Cut, and choose Ultra Key and place it over here, or you can just double tap it with the mouse. Next, we need to sample that color. And sometimes you may have the problem because That's not the first time I'm recording this video, right? Sometimes you may have the problem that you have some blurriness or not all green screen removed. You need to go to the settings and you need to choose aggressive, right? So right now it's not changing. I don't know why, but in my previous example, I had the green screen. I will not be able to find it, but it didn't remove it correctly. So when I choose the aggressive, it was worked perfectly fine. And now we have our subtitles and we have our video. We don't have any green screen. And now if we go to the motion, we can place it however we want. So for example, if you have only one person, like just talking head style video, you would want to place it maybe over here. You also need to remember that the big portion of the video, of the screen is, you have like subscription, you have description, so you need to place it so people can read your subtitles. So, but we will place it in the center, and now we have our clip, and we can easily, because we didn't change the placement of the clips, we can easily just cut it, remove it, and now we have two separate clips with subtitles, and you can have animated, and you can animate them, you can do whatever you want, you can make it bigger, make it smaller, and so on. And that's basically it. I hope that video was helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe, and that's all. Bye-bye.